So how do we do this? So if we think of the diode, that's obviously just an if clause. Yeah, so if this AM signal of T is greater zero, then we just leave it alone. Then do nothing, and else, otherwise we say AM of T becomes zero. Yeah, so that's basically what we need to do for the diode. What is a bit more complicated is here the this one here, so the capacitor and the resistor. So this is essentially a low pass filter. So now we need to translate this low pass filter, this analog one, into a digital one. So how do we turn a low pass filter? How do we create a digital low pass filter? This is surprisingly easy because we are working with Octave from MATLAB. So there's a so-called signal package. Which you might need to load before you can use it. My signal package has two very useful commands. Two commands for this. The one command is called FIR1, and it has argument called n and a frequency. And this gives us a value. So this command FIR1. This generates a low pass filter. Low pass filter with 100 taps and normalized. Normalized cutoff frequency FREQ in this case here. So then the other command, which is quite useful or directly generates our result, is the actual filter command. So if we writing something like Y2 filter and then B comma 1, Y. Then this B here, these are the coefficients which we have generated, and then this filters the signal Y and generates the output Y2. So that's the input signal, and this here is the output signal. And so simple as that. So with these commands, we are absolutely happy for this digital communications program lecture. And these are all commands we need more or less from the signal package. And with that, we can build our demodulator.